Gage screws this up, he knows we'll skin him alive. So shut up and be patient.
What about you, big guy? Nothing to say on the matter?
As long as he doesn't get in the way, don't much care.
Yeah, figured as much.
Both of you just get out of here. Make sure the others get the message.
The new OB, huh? I reckon you're here to talk to Nisha. She's in charge.
Sexy.
If I hear them packing animals talking trash one more time, they're gonna wake up short a few body parts.
Hey, Savoy.
Swear to God, I'll kill them all.
Hey there.
So, you're Gage's little pet project.
And what are you? His grandma?
If I was, I would have slit that little suck-up's throat a long time ago. Gage will never be one of us. He's a failure. He's lucky we're giving him a second chance. Everyone knows we all wanted Coulter dead. Of course, if I had my way, it would have been a slow, painful process. But whatever. Let's get this meet and greet over with. I'm Nisha. I lead the disciples. We've only got one rule around here, and that's keeping the peace of this alliance. Otherwise, the way we see it, this world stopped caring about rules the moment people started dropping bombs on one another.
I bet you guys are great at parties.
Side with us, you'll soon find out. Just don't slack off when it comes to actually doing your job. We got Coulter Nuka Town, and suddenly he forgot the big picture. We both know how that turned out. Although I could give him a little credit. He built the gauntlet, after all. Of course, it was total shit at first. No imagination. But we spiced it up a bit.
How many lives has this gauntlet claimed?
Who's counting? It's at least enough to keep the traders busy. We like to send them in to clean out the bodies whenever things get ripe in there. They don't always make it out alive, of course. The gauntlet never sleeps.
That thing should be shut down. It's dangerous.
Dangerous? People are dangerous. That thing's child's play. Just a bunch of traps and critters. Let's just hope Gage is right about you. He made a lot of promises to get us here. Never followed through. So you better not screw this up, because I'm not about to tolerate another round of bullshit.
Are you questioning me? You're overboss?
Not questioning. Just curious. We were wrong about Coulter. We won't make the same mistake twice.
It depends on what you're looking for.
Someone who's not afraid to get blood on their hands and make some real changes around here. You see, the disciples don't make empty threats. We make good on them. We aren't swayed by caps like those spoiled brats obsessed with their hair, or those savage animals who can't behave in public. Fuck this up, and I will kill you. Although, I admit I have even better plans for Gage. But, if you support us and keep your promises like a good little overboss, we back you. You get to live, and everybody wins.
I don't make promises, and you'll do what I say.
Looks like you're already a step above Coulter. We'll see how this plays out. For now. But if you change your tune and decide to play nice, there's no shortage of work around here. So, if you're looking to prove you've got what it takes, you know where to find me.
Hey, asshole! You're listening to Reader Radio. Hey, little announcement for you idiots out there. You got a new overboss.
Keep your asses out of parts we ain't secured. There's all kinds of weird shit out there.
Come across any herbologist crazies?
You all
just
ever feel
them.
Like you just
those
can't
freaks to
get
stick
enough.
To their camp.
Well, Red Eye hears you, man. He knows what it's like. Well, I've been told it's in our blood, under our skin and all that mud. Doesn't matter if I'm buried in stuff. I just can't ever get enough. I need one last score. I could be sitting on a throne of caps and still need one last score. It ain't about the haul, could just be scraps. Well, I've seen guys lose their mind just trying to hold onto too much trash. They're convinced it's gold, but I can help them out by lighting in their stash. Just by being a good neighbor and pulling in that cash. I need one last score. I can clear out a whole damn town and still need one last score. Take anything that ain't nailed down. See, it ain't really about all the stuff I steal. It's more about this notion, this grand ideal, that I can take whatever, whoever, whenever I please. But sometimes this starts to feel like a disease, cause I can't control it, like an itch that I can't scratch. All that I can do is just add to my stash. I know it won't cure me, but what else can I do? I ain't got anything else to turn to. I need one last score. Maybe that'll make this go away. Just one more score, and I can maybe rest easy someday. It's Red Eye here, running Reader Radio. You love it, and you know it. Hey, little announcement for you idiots out there. We got a new overboss and all, but we're still stuck with the mess Coulter left us in. Unless you want to wind up dead, keep your asses out of parts we ain't secured. There's all kinds of weird shit out there. I ever tell you all about the time I got my name?
So this one time, a long time ago, I'm enjoying myself, you know, out in the combat zone. A few bets, a few drinks, a whole lot of jokes. I'm making friends, having a good time. Now this one guy, he gets jealous. I mean, I can't blame him. It happens to me all the time. People just get upset that they ain't as cool. Anyway, he's this really big guy. I mean, huge guy, actually. I don't remember his name. Doesn't matter. Shut up. So this big idiot decides he's gonna challenge me to a drinking contest. Guess he figures he'll make me look like a fool in front of all the nice folks at the combat zone. So he lumbers up to me, comes up to my table, tells me he can drink me under the table. I'm like, the hell you can, try me. So everybody gathers round because it's clear this is gonna be the coolest thing that happens all night. And we just go at it, just shot after shot after shot. Now, the whole time, he's talking shit about me. I mean, telling me I'm gonna lose, telling me that I'm a piece of shit, you know, all this stuff, and I'm just laughing. I'm laughing, I'm taking my shots. Now, I'm so drunk, and I mean so drunk, that it's crazy. Later on, people were like, man, you were so amazing. I didn't even know how you could still be standing. I've never seen anyone drink that much. And after a while, you know, I see that big guy starting to get wobbly, right? Like he's not gonna last much longer. But you know, I take a minute to make sure that I'm not so drunk that I'm just seeing shit. But I'm right, it's him. He is wobbly. So, you know, I push through it, man. I knuckle down and I keep taking shots. Finally, he just goes face first into the table, out cold, no question. And I'm so pumped up, I pick this guy up. I shit you not, I picked him right up, totally raged out, and then I just, bam, slam him back down onto the floor. And I'm screaming, yeah, man, yeah, who's the best, who's the best? And this one guy, he comes over, he looks at me, and he's like, oh, man, you blew all the blood vessels in your eye, man. That's totally messed up. That's so cool. And then everyone cheers even more, and I was so pumped up, I didn't even feel it. And everyone's all like, yeah, let's hear it for Red Eye. Oh, it was pretty great. You should have been there.
Hey, it's your main man, Red Eye, here, sending out some big congratulations to our brand new overboss. That That's right. If you haven't heard, Coulter is toast. He's worm food. Not only did someone survive the gauntlet, but he took on Coulter and won. I already hear people talking about some secret agreement between Gage and the gangs, saying whoever took down Coulter would take his place. You believe that? I didn't vote for this guy. How come he gets to be overboss? I mean, hell, if I had known they were looking for somebody, I would have thrown my name into that hat. You know what I'm saying? Well, whatever. I can't wait to see what our new leader has planned. At least, can't be any worse than Coulter, right? Right? It's Red Eye here, running Raider Radio. You love it, and you know it. Here's an announcement from Mags Black. To the disciples who found a red ribbon on her bunk this morning, you know what you did, as do we. God, she even writes like a... Sorry, mic is still on. So, I was thinking about the time I came to Nuka World. I ever tell you deadbeats that story? Doesn't matter. I feel like telling it now. Shut up. So, like a year ago, I'm running with this gang. Pretty good deal. I mean, I probably could have been in charge, you know, but whatever. I don't need that kind of hassle, right? I mean, I'm totally capable of running my own gang. Probably the best friggin' gang you've ever seen. But anyway, I hear this dude, Coulter, is putting together a huge-ass team of raiders to take over Nuka World. And I hear this, and I just gotta go check it out. You know, see if it's the real deal. Now, the guys I'm running with, they're all upset that I'm leaving. They're so upset they just keep saying, oh, come on, man, you have to stay. You're the best out of all of us. We're screwed without you. But I'm like, no, man, I ain't gonna let you guys hold me back. So I go out on my own. I travel through some crazy shit you wouldn't believe even if I told you about it. And I wind up here. Now, I find out who Coulter is, and I just march right up to his face and say, well, here I am. Now what? And you can see right away that he was impressed. You know, he looks at me and he says, man, you look like hell. How long has it been since you slept? And I say, well, I don't know, man. Doesn't matter. I can sleep when I'm dead. And you can see on his face that he was totally impressed. Just like he knew I was the real deal. So first he says, man, I am impressed. You're the real deal, Red Eye. I'm gonna call you that because your eyes are bloodshot as hell and it looks really cool. He says, you're gonna be my right-hand man because I can tell just by looking at you that I can count on you. But then, like, he stops and he sees the guitar I'm carrying and he says, oh, no shit, you can play? And I look at him and I say, I don't know, man, can I? Yeah, Coulter, like you said, I am the real deal. And he loses his mind, you know, he's so excited. He says, oh, no way, I got an even more important job for you. Get your ass into that radio station and make it amazing. Well, and here we are. Swear to you, true story. All of it, every word. Of course, Coulter ended up being kind of a chump, but I mean, you know, I knew that from the beginning. Like, I probably could have challenged him right there, you know, made myself the overboss, but, you know, whatever, I like this gig just fine. Yeah. Hey, it's your main man, Red Eye here, sending out some big congratulations to our brand new overboss. That's right, if you haven't heard, Coulter is toast. He's worm food. Not only did someone survive the gauntlet, but he took on Coulter and won. I already hear people talking about some secret agreement between Gage and the gangs, saying whoever took down Coulter would take...
Did you hear something? Should be avoided at all costs. It could damage you irreparably.
Well now, friends, it seems we have another uninvited guest to the park.
condition. Nuclear enemies have been dispatched. Yes? This place is most unsettling.
And now... I'll admit, I didn't think you'd make it this far. I can tell you're different than the usual invaders, so I'll not bother with the usual tricks and illusions I use to scare off the superstitious. When the bombs fell, everything changed. We changed. And somehow, I received a gift. Actual magic. The stuff of legends. Perhaps you'd like to see some. Up! No matter what you do, I can heal my friends, and we will protect what is ours.
There is some...
belongs in the garbage can, yes?
There we go.
Thank you.
Must have pulled a few strings if someone like you is in charge now. Coca-Cola song stuck in my head again. Things are boring as hell since Nisha made us team up. I ain't no fan of playing nice with others. That last one died too fast.
Shots. Now, I'm so drunk, and I mean so drunk, that it's crazy. Later on, people were like, man, you were so amazing. I didn't even know how you could still be standing. I've never seen anyone drink that much. And after a while, you know, I see that big guy starting to get wobbly, right? Like he's not gonna last much longer. But you know, I take a minute to make sure that I'm not so drunk that I'm just seeing shit. But I'm right, it's him. He is wobbly. So, you know, I push through it, man. I knuckle down, and I keep taking shots. Finally, he just goes face first into the out cold, no question. And I'm so pumped up, I pick this guy up. I shit you not, I pick
hey.
Him right
Do
up,
you need something
totally
from me?
Raged out, and then I just, bam, slam him back down onto the floor.
Over here. Hey.
May I be of assistance?
That everyone cheers.
Are you giving me a present?
I was so pumped up, I didn't even feel it. And everyone's all like, yeah, let's hear it for Red Eye. It was pretty great. You should have been there. Hey, asshole. You're listening to Raider Radio. Announcement for you idiots out there. We got a new overboss and all, but we're still stuck with the mess Colton left us in. Unless you want to wind up dead, keep your asses out of parts we ain't secured. There's all kinds of weird shit out there. So, I was thinking about the time I came to Nuka World. I ever tell you deadbeats that story? Doesn't matter. I feel like telling it now. Shut up. So, like a year ago, I'm running with this gang. Pretty good deal. Yeah, I probably could have been in charge, you know, but whatever. I don't need that kind of hassle, right? I mean, I'm totally capable of running my own gang. Probably the best friggin' gang you've ever seen. Anyway, I hear this dude, Coulter, is putting together a huge-ass team of raiders to take over Nuka World. I hear this, and I just gotta go check it out. Leaving. They're so upset they just keep saying, oh, come on, man, you have to see. You're the best out of all of us. We're screwed with
Welcome home, boss. The digs are yours now. I hope you like the look. Coulter had some peculiar tastes. But this view is something, huh? Everything you see here...
Gage.
Welcome home, boss. The digs are yours now. I hope you like the look. Coulter had some peculiar tastes. But this view is something, huh? Everything you see here is under your control, now that you're in charge.
Yeah, I still don't get it. Why put me in charge?
You may have noticed that our former overboss, Coulter, was a fucking asshole. And that's me being nice. Ended up being poison for this whole operation. The way I see it, surviving the gauntlet means you've got what it takes. Or at least the potential. For a good while now, we've needed someone who can get shit done, make real progress.
I sure do like the sound of that.
I thought you might. Look, I'll be honest with you. This operation needs someone to step in and take the reins. Sure as hell ain't gonna be me. Leading outright ain't my style. And there's already some blaming me for supporting Coulter all this time. My talents are best put to use helping a new overboss get all this shit under control. You get me?
Oh, sure. I understand. So, are you just gonna paint the bullseye directly on my back, or what?
I ain't gonna lie. It's a part of the reason you won't see me stepping up and running things. But I'm telling you, it ain't gonna be that bad. Let's take a step back and talk big picture, okay? Nuka World. Shit. This was the dream. Huge. Built like a goddamn fortress. You run this, world is yours. We had a good head start on it. A lot of work went into getting the disciples, the operators, and the pack to work together. But we got here. About a year ago, we push in through the front gate. Take over Nuka Town. Get these traitors under our thumb. And then... Well, Coulter got lazy. He was content to sit on his ass. Never bothered putting in the effort to finish taking over the park. The gangs got restless and started pissing each other off. It was... is... a real mess.
Wait, what kind of mess am I walking into here?
It was little shit at first. Heated tempers, arguments, the occasional shooting. Got worse over time, though. Gangs started staking out as much territory as they could. All being on top of each other like this. Started looking for excuses to turn on each other. If something ain't done soon to settle things down, it's gonna reach a point there ain't no coming back from.
I can fix this. I can make this work.
Yeah? Man, I sure hope so. So, seems like you're the... jump in head first kind of overboss, huh? Here you've already chatted up all the gang leaders. Yeah, you're back in one piece. That's a good sign. Everything all peachy with our friendly neighborhood psychopaths? Sure hope you didn't promise them too much. I mean, going a little over the top is part of the game, but you don't want them holding it against you if you can't deliver.
They'll do what they're told. That's all that matters.
Oh boy, okay. Time to roll up your sleeves, boss. There's work to be done. This place is huge. Divided up into sections. Parks, whatever the hell they called them back in the day. We need to take them all back. One at a time. Every section we secure gives us a little more breathing room and more resources. You stake a claim, plant a little flag for one of the gangs, and that settles it. It's theirs for good. Who gets what, that'll be your call. Whoever you hand it off to will appreciate it, but the others might get a little jealous. You know how it goes.
I thought the whole point of having minions was to get them to do the dirty work.
Yeah, yeah, give it time. You still got to prove to them you're worth following, remember? So that's it. Nice and simple, right? Take a minute. Settle in if you want. And then let's get to it. And hey... we're in this together, so I might as well go all in. You want me watching your back? You just say the word.
That sounds like a great idea, Gage. You've got a deal.
You're the overboss.
It on their own. Well, it makes for easy pickings, I guess. Fan of antiques, boss.
Sure, we carry guns, but knives are where it's at. It's not fun unless you're up close and personal.
Hey, here's a friendly reminder.
Sure, nobody likes traitors, but you can't kill them all, or else there wouldn't be anyone around to do all that shitty work you assholes won't do. Think about it.
This next one, I've been hearing some shit that I ripped this off, or whatever. Hey, Trick, I wrote this. I swear.
Red Eye Original, you could say.
Close to something good. I can feel it.
Things will get better. One day.
Thank you. Attention. We're happy to announce that Mad Mulligan's minecart ride has finally reopened, with stronger restraints following last year's tragedy. Attention guests, the last outbound tram to the Nuka World Transit Center will be leaving the park promptly at 11:55 p.m. Thank you.
Attention.